إن الحمد لله، نحمده تعالى ونستعينه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا، يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله والرسول فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم he got up upon this member, the member of the Muslims, on يوم الجمعة like a day like this, and he said آمين 3 times. And the Sahaba asked him afterwards, you did something يا رسول الله that we've never seen you do before. He said آمين as you stood up on the member. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said أتاني جبريل، جبريل came to me. فقال رضم أنف امرئ، رضم أنف امرئ. رضم أنف امرئ. جبريل said to him لا إله إلا Jibreel said to him, رَضِمَ أَنْفُ امْرِئٍ, that may he be humiliated. May he be humiliated, the one أَدْرَكَ رَمَضَان فَلَمْ يُغْفَرْ لَهُ. Ramadan approached him and he wasn't forgiven. Now we as Muslims, we are in 3 different scenarios. Every single one of us that is fasting today, 3 different scenarios. The first person, as Allah says in the Quran, فَمِنْهُمْ ظَالِمٌ لِنَفْسِهِ وَمِنْهُمْ مُقْتَسِدٌ وَمِنْهُمْ سَابِقٌ بِالْخَيْرَاتِ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. That from them is the one who has oppressed himself, who's done ظلم on himself. So those of you that are fasting today, they are from amongst you, those who are doing dhulm on themselves. They're doing dhulm on themselves because Ramadan has come and they're not taking any advantage of it. Ramadan has come and it's like another month for them. Ramadan has come and they make any sacrifices to get closer to Allah. And then the second group, وَمِنْهُمْ مُقْتَصِدْ, the one who's in the middle, who's taken the middle course, he makes efforts, he stays away from food and drink, but he doesn't, that's where his fasting stops. He won't go the extra mile, he won't realize that this is a season of ibadah, and he'll stay in the middle, he'll do what he has to do and that's it, and he waits for Ramadan to finish. And the third person, سَابِقٌ بِالْخَيْرَاتِ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. سَابِقٌ بِالْخَيْرَاتِ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ, the one who races, competes, and he's at the forefront to do good deeds with the permission of Allah. The one who wants to read the Quran and he will complete the Quran as many times as he can. The one who wants to not let a night of Ramadan go except that he's prayed salah. The one who whenever he finds out there's a charity or a cause, he wants to be the first to pay for it. The one when he finds out people are breaking their fast, he wants to be the one that pays for their iftar or provides the food for them. And this is the one who becomes excited. This is the one who becomes elated when he hears the hadith of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As he would say when to his companions, أَتَاكُمْ شَهْرُ رَمَضَانِ, the month of Ramadan has come to you. شهر مبارك, a blessed month, شهر تفتح فيه أبواب الجنة, the month in which the doors of Jannah are opened, وتغلق فيه أبواب الجحيم, and the doors of Jahannam are shut, وتغل فيه مردة الشياطين, and the evil, the heads of Shaytan, they're all locked away. أيها المؤمن, كيف لا تستبشر بفتح أبواب الجنان؟ The believer, how can you not rejoice and be excited by the doors of Jannah being opened? Right now as we speak, the doors of Jannah open. أيها المذنب, كيف لا تستبشر؟ كيف لا تستبشر بغلق أبواب النيران؟ The one who is sinning, how can you not rejoice? The one who is drowning right now in sin, how can you not rejoice when the doors of Jahannam have been shut right now as we speak? أيها العاقل, كيف لا تستبشر؟ كيف لا تستبشر بوقت تصفد فيه الشياطين؟ You who's got an ounce of intelligence, how can you not? How can you not rejoice at a time when the shayateen have been locked away? And this is why the Prophet ﷺ continued to say, وَيُنَادِي مُنَادٍ وَيُنَادِي مُنَادٍ, and a caller calls out, يَا بَاغِيَ الْخَيْرِ أَقْبِلْ وَيَا بَاغِيَ الشَّرِّ أَقْصِرْ. O seeker of good, come forward. The one who wants to read the Qur'an, come forward and read the Qur'an. The one who wants to give sadaqah, come forward and give your sadaqah. The one who wants to pray qiyam, come forward and pray qiyam. The one who wants to read the Qur'an, come forward and complete the Qur'an. وَيَا بَاغِيَ الشَّرِّ أَقْصِرْ. And you who seeks evil, stop what you're doing. You who's talking to a woman that is not allowed to talk to, or she's doing haram with her, stop what you're doing. You the one who's taking money from riba, stop what you're doing. You the one who is selling drugs on the streets and destroying the youth of the Muslims, stop what you're doing. You the one who's taking those drugs, stop what you're doing, because this is the month, this is the season. And this is why Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when he said, when this caller calls out, why is he calling out? Why is he telling the seeker of good to come forward? Why is he telling the seeker of good, the evil, to stop? Because وَلِلَّهِ عُتَقَاءُ مِنَ النَّارِ وَذَٰلِكَ فِي كُلِّ لَيْلَةِ. Every single night of this month, Allah is giving tickets out. Yes, every single night of this month, Allah is giving tickets out for me and you to be saved from the fire. Tickets for your neck, for my neck, to be saved from the fire. Not some fire of this world, but a fire whose fuel is people and stone. A fire that will not be diminished. A fire that will not distinguish. A fire that will burn your skin over and over again because you disobeyed and were rebellious with Allah. Nothing will be able to stop this. And this is why Allah is giving you free tickets now. Every night of Ramadan, there's tickets for you to save your neck from the fire. Every single night of Ramadan, كل ليلة, as the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said. That woman that you're sleeping with, that money and that haram that you're taking, those drugs that you're doing, ask yourself this question, Ya Abdullah, is it really worth it? Are they really worth you throwing away the ticket to have your neck saved from the fire? وَاللَّهُ يُرِيدُ أَن يَتُوبَ عَلَيْكُمْ وَيُرِيدُ الَّذِينَ يَتَّبِعُونَ الشَّهَوَاتِ أَن تَمِيلُوا مَيْلًا عَظِيمًا. And Allah wants to forgive you. Allah wants to accept your repentance when you turn to Him. But those who follow their desires and are sinful, that evil company that you keep, they want what? For you to turn away from this beautiful rahmah of Allah that has come this season. They want you to turn away from that. And they want you to stay with them in evil. But Allah wants every night. Allah gives you that chance. You missed out 9 nights of Ramadan. Still, there's more nights to come. Tonight is still there. You're still alive. Turn back to Allah. Turn back to Allah, Ya Abdullah. The one who's drowning in sins, turn back to Allah in this night. And then Allah says in the Quran, قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله. Oh, you've wasted yourself in sins. You're drowning in sins, and all you're doing is taking haram, living haram life. Allah is saying, don't give up hope in the mercy of Allah. You think that, look what I've done, I've committed zina, I've got a child of zina, I've got haram money, all my wealth is haram, everything I'm doing is haram. Wallahi, until your heart is still beating, you have not lost any hope. And that's why we say, don't lose your hope in Allah. Don't lose your hope in the mercy of Allah. Because when you do that, that's when you disbelieve. So long as your heart is beating, know that in these nights, Allah is saving people from the fire. Every single night, Allah is saving people from the fire. May Allah make me and you from those people who are saved from the fire. And then, I want to move on to the next point. The point of what this month is about. Allah said, كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ السِّيَامِ. Fasting has been ordained for you. As-siyam, for those of you that really want this month to be worthwhile, then know what this purpose is for this siyam. Why do we fast? لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. And don't be duped by anybody else. Don't be deluded by what they're saying now, by making the whole thing about fasting. There's like a hamla now out there to say fasting has got all these health benefits. It makes you like this. It helps you to think about the poor. These are all perks. They're not the primary purpose of our fast. And that is to worship Allah and to get taqwa and to get closer to Allah. As the Prophet ﷺ narrates from Allah himself, كُلُّ عَمَلْ إِبْنِ آدَمْ لَهُ. Every single action of Ibn Adam is for himself. Because you're going to get a reward for every deed that you do. الْحَسَنَةُ بِعَشْرِ أَمْثَالِهَا إِلَى سَبْعِمِئَةِ ضِعْفِ. The good deed is multiplied from 10 to 700. إِلَّا الصِّيَامِ. What is Allah saying? Every good action is yours, you're going to get a reward for, except for siyam, except for fasting. What does that mean? فَإِنَّهُ لِي وَأَنَا أَجْزِي بِهِ. Allah says, fasting, the fast that you make, it's for me, and I am the one who personally recompenses. I am the one who personally rewards us. Let me put this into some context, an example for you to think about. Most of you here are perhaps employed, working in a company. Imagine you working for a company that is multi-trillion pound, trillionaire company. It's got the world's richest man is the head of this company, the founder of this company. You get your salary every month, and if you do your overtime, you get paid your overtime. But now you have an announcement. Not from your line manager, not from your regional manager, but from the big man himself, the head of the company, the founder, the CEO, this richest man in the world. And he says to you, I've got one job to do. Whoever does this job, I will personally reward him. You don't even know what that reward is, but you're all gonna rush to do this. Why? Not because of the reward itself, but because who is rewarding you. And because who is going to know you afterwards? Who you're gonna get a contact afterwards? وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلُ الْأَعْلَى. And for Allah is the greatest example. If we were to do this for the dunya, if we were to do this مَا عِنْدَكُمْ يَنْفَدْ, for that which diminishes, the wealth of this world which diminishes. وَمَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ بَاقٍ. And what with Allah is remains forever and is everlasting. Then why not to seek that which is with Allah, which does not diminish? And that's why this is very important, that we correct our intention and we do this for Allah. First and foremost, put aside all these other things, they're perks. You think about Ramadan, I'm gonna get healthier lifestyle, I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna do that. Those are fine, make those goals for your worldly life, but don't make that the purpose of your siyam. Know that you're doing this because you want taqwa, and that is the greatest thing. That's why the famous hadith, Nabi ﷺ said, إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَّاتِ. Actions are governed by the intentions. وَإِنَّمَا لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مَا نَوَى. And for every man, he's gonna get what he intended. And that's why Nabi ﷺ gave the example. فَمَنْ كَانَتْ هِجْرَتُهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ فَهِجْرَتُهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. Whoever makes hijrah for Allah and His Messenger, then his reward is Allah and His Messenger. That's how great it is. وَمَنْ كَانَتْ هِجْرَتُهُ لِدُنْيَا يُصِيبُهَا أَوْ إِمْرَأَةٍ يَنْكِحُهَا. Whoever makes hijrah for the dunya to get some wealth, or for a woman to marry her, فهجرته إلى ما هاجر إليه. Then his hijrah is for whatever he went to. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam didn't even mention the reward, because there's no reward. It's not even worth mentioning. He said, whatever it was. So وَإِنَّمَا لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مَا نَوَى. Every man is gonna get what he intended. If you intended from this fast to get your health benefits and that's it, then you get that and the month has gone by and nothing's happened. But if you got it for Allah, then Allah said, فَإِنَّهُ لِي وَأَنَا أَجْزِي بِهِ. It's for me and I will personally reward it. You will have gained that taqwa. And so make sure your niyyah, your intention is for Allah alone and not for these other side things, these perks. Don't make them the most important thing about this month. And finally, Al-Qur'an, Al-Qur'an. Allah says about this month himself, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. Make no mistake. This is the month of Ramadan in which the Qur'an was revealed in. That's what makes this month blessed. That's what makes this month the special month, because in it was revealed the Qur'an. So now is the time to get your relationship with this book of Allah. We don't get time in the year. We're too busy. And that's why Allah, as mercy from Him, has given this special month for me and you to get closer to Allah with this Quran, with the book of Allah. If you look on your phone now and you open your phone and you check settings, I don't know what, iPhones or Android, whichever one, you'll see how much usage you've had of the apps. And you'll see all the social media apps and all these things. Most of us will have WhatsApp or something, YouTube, and all these apps will be there. If you read the Quran on your phone, have a look and see where that is. Have a look now and see where that is and reflect and see where that should be. This is the month where Allah has given you the opportunity to increase your relationship with the Quran. If you don't do it in this month, you won't do it in the rest of the year. This is the month of the Quran, my brothers. And so let's make that effort to build our relationship with the book of Allah. And in reading the book of Allah, understanding the book of Allah, and trying to memorize what we can in the book of Allah. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وحده، الصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده. There's 7 acts of ibadah that I want you to focus on and think about in this month. Make note of at least the first 5. Everybody can do, inshallah. The first 5, everybody can do. The first thing is what we're all doing right now, as-siyam. This is the obligatory of this month, to do siyam. As the Prophet ﷺ said, من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Whoever fasts the entire month of Ramadan, then all his sins are forgiven. The second worship is what we do in the nights, and that is al-qiyam. And Nabi ﷺ said in the same hadith, وَمَنْ قَامَ رَمَضَانَ إِيمَانًا وَاحْتِسَابًا غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ. And whoever stands in the nights of Ramadan with iman and seeking the reward, then all his sins are forgiven. This is the second thing. The third thing is al-Qur'an, like we mentioned. Increase in your reading of the Qur'an. كان جبريل يلقاه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في كل ليلة فيدارسه القرآن. Every night of Ramadan, في كل ليلة من رمضان. Every night of Ramadan, جبريل would come to the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم and they would study the Quran together. He would read the Quran to جبريل, like how a student reads to the teacher. And in the last Ramadan of the Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم, he read to it in the entire Quran to جبريل 2 times. So this is our goal. To read the Qur'an at least once, twice if you can, more if you can, even better. That's the third one, al-Qur'an. The fourth one, al-du'a. Al-du'a, al-du'a. Turn to Allah and raise your hands to Allah. Don't you think, oh believer, when you read the ayat of siyam and have a little bit of tadabbur, what does Allah mention between the ayat of siyam? When Allah is talking about shahru Ramadan and this is unzila fihi al-Qur'an, and Allah is talking about the rulings of fasting, what does Allah bring in the middle? Which middle ayah does Allah say? وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ. That when my, Allah is saying to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when my slaves ask you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, about me, Allah doesn't say tell them. Allah doesn't say faqul. Allah says fa'inni qareeb. Then know that I am close to them. Ujibu da'wat al-da'i idha da'an. And I will answer the prayer of the one who calls me. The one who calls Allah alone, Allah will answer him. And Allah is mentioning this ayah in between the ayat of siyam. Open your eyes to realize this great ibadah. So number four is a dua. And number five, nuzum al-masajid. Staying in the masajid. Filling up the masajid as we see these days. Continue filling them up. Don't lose this passion that is inside you right now. Continue to come to the masjid for every salah if you can. And especially in the last 10 nights. Those of you that can do i'tikaf, then they should do i'tikaf. And if you can't make the 10 nights, then at least come to the masjid with the intention from the time of Maghrib when the sun sets up until sunrise, al-ishraq, when the sun rises. If you stay in that time, then inshallah you've done i'tikaf for the night. The minimum that we can try and do in the last 10 nights of Ramadan. And number six and number seven, and these are the things for those people who Allah has blessed with wealth. If Allah has granted you with wealth, then go and perform Umrah in this month. If Allah has given you the means and the wealth and the health to go to perform Umrah, then do your best to perform Umrah. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, إِنَّ عُمْرَةَ فِي رَمَضَانَ تَعْدِلُ حَجَّةَ الْمَعِي. That Umrah in Ramadan is like the reward of doing Hajj with who? With Al-Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Who here doesn't want to do Hajj with Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam saying here, this is the opportunity. You have the means, you do Umrah in Ramadan, and it's like you've done Hajj with Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Imagine the reward of that. And finally, the last one, to feed the people. Feed the people and to provide food for them when they open their fast. Like happens every day in this masjid. If you can provide yourself, alhamdulillah. If you can't and you have the wealth, then pay for those people who are catering, for those people who are providing people with food, then give them the money. Because you will get the reward. فَلَهُ مِثْلُ أَجْرِهِ لَا يَنْقُسْ مِنْهُ شَيْءٍ. He will get the reward of the fasting person. You yourself are fasting. And we already established how great that reward is. And now you're getting the reward of every single person that breaks his fast as well. Whether you feed him, as the ulama say, whether you feed him at the start of his fast, in the middle, or even for his suhoor, all these times, whenever you're feeding the fasting person during this month, then you will get the reward of the fast of the fasting person. So, ذَلِكَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ يُؤْتِيهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. This is the favor of Allah, and Allah gives it to who He wills. There are only so many people that have been blessed with wealth and been blessed with it in abundance. And they are the ones who are able to fulfill these amazing acts. But I now speak to you, the one who is able to do these things. Say Alhamdulillah. Because around you are people who are like you. They have wealth. They have the means. But they don't do that. They won't make a trip to Umrah. They won't even think about it. It won't even cross their mind. And they won't even think about feeding people. Whether it be here or in other countries, they don't want to feed people. And they just want to care about their own food. And Allah has given them the means. So if you have the wealth and you are able to do this, then this is Allah giving you something far greater than all of us can achieve. ذَلِكَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ يُؤْتِيهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. This is the bounty of Allah, and Allah gives it to who He wills. أَلَا وَصَلُّ وَسَلِّمُوا عَلَى النَّبِي مُحَمَّدٍ صلى الله عليه وسلم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي. يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم. وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم. إنك حميد مجيد. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. We ask Allah in this blessed month, in these blessed nights, that we turn to Him in repentance and He accepts the repentance from us. We ask Allah that He forgives us from all our sins. We ask Allah with all His beautiful names that He makes us from those who are freed from the fire in this month. We ask Allah that He saves us, our parents, our families, and our progeny from the fire, and that He accepts from us our good deeds. We get ready for salat.